Hi, welcome everybody to the My Dream Team Freedom Fridays. My name is Scott and you are here with My Dream Team. And what we are is a group of online individuals that are focused on helping you build your business within MLSP, which is My Lead System Pro. Now, we're not going to go ahead and go into what all MLSP is all about. However, you're more than welcome to go ahead and at some point there's going to be a link up around this box and you're more than welcome to click that link. So you can go ahead and connect with one of us and get in on what this is all about. Now, as usual tonight, we have Miguel Fuentes in the house. What's up, Miguel?
What's going on, guys? Freedom Friday. Rock it.
And we got Samantha Rodriguez going on. How you doing tonight?
Hello, hello.
And we have our guest of honor tonight, Miss Laura Parrish. How you doing tonight, Laura?
I'm doing awesome. Thanks for having me on.
You know, I just want to go ahead and give a quick introduction. Laura right now is one of those movers and shakers that is in our company, MLSP, and she's climbing the leaderboards, and we've had the opportunity to go ahead and see her and all the great things that she's doing, and I can't wait for her to go ahead and share her story and tell us exactly what she's doing to go ahead and build her business. So without any further ado, I'd like to let Laura go ahead and take the floor. It's all yours. Take it away.
Are you sure you want to do that? We might be here for a few hours. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm sure it'd be worth it.
I think it'd be worth it. Absolutely.
Yeah. Can you go ahead?
Oh, sorry. Go ahead, Laura. I'm just trying to hear your story. I actually saw you come onto the scene, and the first time I knew about you or heard about you, you were already L2. I was like, holy cow, she's just flying through the ranks. I can't even believe how quickly she's moving through, and just like every other day you got a new person. So that was just like blew my mind. I was instantly curious about you. So you got to share with us like your story and how things are going for you.
No, I appreciate that. I just want to make sure, can everybody see me and hear me okay? That's good. Awesome. Okay, well, like these awesome people said, my name is Laura Parrish, and I've actually been in the internet marketing industry for almost 4 years. I am a simple stay-at-home mom. I have a beautiful 8-year-old daughter and a 5-year-old son that drive me absolutely insane. If you're a parent, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But, you know, quite honestly, I wanted to be a stay-at-home mom, and I feel like a lot of people out there have families that, you know, either the mom or the dad want to stay home with their kids. And the problem is the finances, right? So when I've been married for almost 15 years, I think, 14 years, something like that. It's pretty sad when you've been married so long you don't remember the days, right? But when we decided to have kids, I said I wanted to stay home, and that was fine. But I was a restaurant manager, and he was a restaurant manager. So between the two of us, we were making like 120 grand a year. And then when we had kids, that got cut in half, and it's like, whoa. So you'd say, well, 60 grand's, you know, decent money. It is, but when you have kids, it's really not, because kids are expensive. And so we struggled. We really, really struggled. I got into the industry in May of 2012, and I just wanted something. I wanted to find a way to help with the finances, and there was a couple reasons. One, because I was tired of not being able to pay a babysitter to even be able to go on a date with my spouse, right? I was tired of not even, you know, being able to take the family out to dinner because we couldn't afford it. You know, we got the bills paid, but that was it. And so many people in this day and age struggle like that, and I was really tired of it, especially being an independent A-type personality like I am. I missed that. I missed that, you know, ability to go to work and, you know, suit up, show up, and everything I've ever done in my life I've given 110% at, you know. So it's like even if you start here, you end up here because you just work hard because you desire success, you desire to achieve success. And I miss that part of me. As great as it is to be a parent, you still at times miss being able to do what you want to do, right? And so I wanted that back too, and I'm like, what can I do? And I started looking online to see if there was something I could find. But the bottom line is I was bound and determined to change my circumstances. And, you know, that's a huge piece of advice that, you know, a nugget that I can give anyone is you have to make a decision first. And with that decision comes hell or high water, nothing, allow no one, no circumstance, nothing to deter you from that. Because when you make a decision and a commitment to do something, then there's just no stopping you. You know, you just got to take the action. So that was the decision I made. And I'm also, this is a big part of my story, and this is one of the ways that I really connect with a lot of people. I'm a recovering alcoholic. I've been sober for almost 5 years, so about 4 years and 10 months. And that's a huge part of my story because, you know, I used to not live right. You know, I used to get in trouble for drinking and driving and living wrong. And I really completely transformed my life. And, you know, when I talk about those stories and where I was at then and where I'm at now, people are like, there's no way. And, like, you just don't know. And this is proof positive that it doesn't matter because so many people are afraid and scared, well, I've done this in my life, or I wasn't always the best person, or I didn't always make the best decisions, or I don't have a college education, or I don't have a high school diploma, and they have all these excuses about why they can't change their life and why they can't have success. And I'm proof, you know, proof pudding that, you know, whatever you want to do, you can. What you've done in your past, the decisions you've made in your past do not define who you are. You have absolutely every opportunity to become the best version of yourself and do exactly what you want to do in life. And I've done that. So I got into internet marketing, and it was really frustrating at first, like it is for most everyone, you know, because it's like you feel like you're doing the right things and you're marketing like crazy and spending all this time in front of your computer, because it is, you know. So many people get into this game and they think, oh, great, I'll work from home and money will just fall into my lap if I sit in front of my computer for 15 minutes a day. And I've got to be quite blunt, honest with everyone. Internet marketers, home-based business owners, are the most hardest working people I know, all right? Because it's not easy, right? If you go to a job, you have someone looking over your shoulder telling you, do this, finish that, you can go to lunch here, you do this, and you go home and don't worry about anything until the next day. But when you work for yourself and own your own business, you're responsible for that. You're responsible to suit up and to show up to run your business, to either make money, or if you don't run your business, you don't make money. So it's really important. So, you know, I was ready for it, though. I was gung-ho, and I spent a lot of time. You know, when you first get started, you work and work and grind, and I was really frustrated because I felt like I just wasn't achieving anything. And the funny thing is we always tend to overcomplicate things, don't we? I was trying so hard to convince people that what I do is not a scam, right? Because everybody's like, oh, it's not real. How do I know it's not a scam? And, you know, it's kind of like that saying, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink, right? You know, I can know something is real, but I can't make someone else believe anything. And I spent so much time trying to change everybody's mindset, you know? And it wasn't until I learned that you can't do that. You know, there are people who won't get it and will never get it. And that's okay. You know, not everybody wants to do what we do. You know, and thankfully, think about it. Thank goodness for the people who have a passion to be a doctor, right? Thank goodness for the people who are passionate about being lawyers to help us when we need help. Thank goodness for the people who are passionate about being veterinarians so they can take care of our animals. Thank goodness for the people who are passionate about running restaurants and businesses so that we have a place to take our families. So I always tell everyone, and I've learned this, I'm not here to convince you of anything. I'm not here to talk you into anything. I'm simply here to share with you that I have been able to do what I want to do, which is stay home with my family and create the results that I wanted to create because I was passionate about wanting the freedom of time to live the way that I wanted with my family. And some people are passionate about, you know, wanting to work all the time, you know, whatever they do, doctor, lawyer, restaurant manager, owner, whatever. But that's what I'm passionate about. And the biggest piece for me is I didn't see a lot of success, and I shared this on stage in April of 2013. I spoke on stage for the first time ever in front of about 6,000 people in Chicago in the Rosemont Theater, and I shared, you know, that my breakthrough really, really came when I stopped worrying about the almighty dollar, when I stopped saying, man, I got to make money, I want to make money, I want to make money, I want to do this, I want to do this. When I stopped worrying about making money, and I really started worrying about listening to people and helping people and serving people and saying, hey, what's your story? What is it that you need? What is your circumstance? How can I serve you? Because really, that's the biggest gift in all of this. I'd be a liar if I said the money wasn't great. You know, income disclosure out the yin-yang. But the biggest reward is being able to even play a small part in someone's journey. in someone going from where I was at to where I'm at now simply by sharing themselves. We try so hard to sell our businesses, right? Don't. I tell everybody, don't sell your business. If somebody wanted to join a business just to join a business, everybody would join under the main person who created the business, right? Because they obviously have the best results because they created it, you know, the owners or founders or whatever. But people join under people. People join people. And it's about connections. And that's how I've been able to have so much success in what I've done in this industry as a multiple six-figure earner. And I love being part of MLSP because there is no better culture and community out there than what you will find inside of My Lead System Pro. I can guarantee you that. It's just a support, you know, when you can get in a group and talk to the founder of the company, I mean, Brian's always around, right? Like, just answer your questions, boom, right there he is. It's just absolutely amazing. And I love it. You know, I love to serve the people. And when I can be of service to others, that is the best reward for me. So I guess another big thing that has really drawn attraction to me is that I did everything on a shoestring budget, right? Most people who are new in this industry can't afford to pay for marketing, and I have never paid for marketing except for once. I tried something, right? And I felt like I totally, like, it didn't work out for me, and I just didn't like it. So I said, you know, that's just not for me. That's like, you know, cold market. You know, you get people, and, you know, if they're not interested, whatever, even they join, they won't stay. And I just want to talk to people. I want to know how I can be of service to people. And when you commit to people like that and they join your team, they stay with you forever because loyalty is really strong. And I really use this this terminology, and I use it with my team. It's like a plant. How many of you guys out there have ever, you know, gotten a fern or a plant, you know, as a gift, or you just went and bought one? And you get so excited. It's like sitting right there, and you're like, oh, my new plant, it's so awesome. And you're like watering it, and you love it. You know, and then the next thing, you know, it's starting to get a little bigger, but it's kind of in the way. So you move it to the side a little bit, and you do your thing, and then the newness of it wears off. And so you're still watering it, but, you know, you're just not paying as much attention to it. And then it gets bigger, and it's in the way. So then before you know it, the plant is over there in the corner of the room, right? And what happens when you don't water your plants anymore? What happens when you don't take care of them? What happens when you just forget about them? They wilt and they wither away and they die. And internet marketers so often don't understand why they can't keep a team, why they can't build a team, why everyone's leaving their team, why they're going to something else. And the question that you always have to do is look in the mirror and say, what is my piece in this? What is my responsibility in this? Because I promise you, if you don't take care of your team, they will find someone else to take care of them. And the biggest thing that like a lot of people in the industry don't understand is, you are responsible for your success and your failure. It is not your sponsor's responsibility to make you successful or to make you a failure, right? It is yours. But I always tell people, it certainly doesn't hurt to have someone in your corner, right? It certainly doesn't hurt to have someone who is willing to get on the phone with you or get on team calls with you every week to motivate you, to inspire you, and say, hey, I'm not telling you to do this because I think you should do it. I'm telling you to do this because, by golly, I'm doing it too, and look at the results I'm getting, right? You know, the technical aspect, I also said this on stage in Chicago. I said, you know, I could give you everything I do because people are like, what's the secret? What's the secret, right? Everybody wants to know the secret. And I'm like, I could tell you everything I do on Facebook. I could tell you the ads that I post, where I post them, what I say, how I respond to people. I could give it all to you. I could just give it all to you. I could. And it doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean that you'll get the same results, because until you have a belief in what you're doing and a passion for what you're doing, you will not have any results, right? I just talked to my team on my last team call about the three C's, and it was funny because everybody knows what the three C's are, right? And I'm like, I told them, I said, I want to know what the three C's are. You guys tell me. And, you know, they were spouting all stuff like create and capture and, you know, all the stuff and conversions and stuff like that. And I'm like, wrong, 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 wrong. I'm like, what are you talking about? And I got on my big whiteboard back there, and I pulled it up, and I talked about, you know, wherever you're at in your life, write it all down. And then, like, write how you feel about it out, like if you're stuck on stuff. And then stand back and write the things that come to your mind when you see those, like one word. And I had done that. And I did this a while ago, and what I found, for me at least, is that the biggest thing that's at my core for me is culture, community, and compensation, right? Because here's the thing, those other three C's that everybody thinks are the big three C's, like create, capture, and convert, and all that, right? It's cool, and you have to be able to do that to have success, yes. But if you don't have, if you're not part of a good culture and an amazing community that has a compensation plan that can really help change people's lives, then those other C's don't matter, right? You have to focus on the three C's I talked about first, at least for me, and that's how it works for me. So I love MLSP. I'm super excited. I joined MLSP on December 19th, right? So I'm literally brand new, and I'm looking to be rebuilds and all that. I'm looking to be L3 on February 10th. I'm super excited about it, and I have some other announcements to make too, but I don't know that I can make them publicly yet, so I'm kind of holding off on that. But I'm just super excited to be a part of the community. And all these people, you know, that I never knew were out here and haven't met before have just been, you know, flooding in and talking to me. And I just love it because if you can provide value and service to other people, there is no limit to your success. And that's just all there is to it. So that's a little bit of my story. I hope I didn't, like, talk too long.
That's a powerful, powerful, very, very powerful, powerful.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, good. Laura, what would you say is your biggest people that have families, how did they manage their families the best? Like, what is your tip for, like, if you have a family and you're working a job and you're building a business and you're really, really busy, like, what do you tell people in that situation? Because I know a lot of people are in that situation.
You mean, if there is a reason. I think one of them.
Like, because you mentioned in your story that you were building a business at the same time you were raising your family. You know, you had a husband, the kids, everything. Like, how do you balance it all? Like, what is your kind of some strategies for people to kind of squeeze it all together and make it effective and actually have some success?
Yeah. When I first got started, I got to tell you, I cried, right? Like, you guys know, you ladies, guys, you, everybody that's in this industry, you know, it's hard work, right? It's no joke. It's hard work. And I did something that I never thought I would do, right? Because I'm not one of those parents who, you know, wants to sit their kids in front of a video game or a TV to, like, that be their babysitter, right? But when I got into this industry, I was determined to make it work. And so I did. I used the TV as a babysitter, and I'll tell you exactly how I do it. I would sit my kids in front of, like, a show like Dora, like a 30-minute show, right? And they'd watch Dora. And then I'd take a break, and we'd, like, eat a snack or whatever. And then I'd put them back in front of the show for 30 minutes. And then, like, I would work, and then we would take a break and play a game together, you know? And I did that. And I had a lot of guilt about that. You know, maybe I shouldn't be saying this, but I always keep it real. I had a lot of guilt about it. But you know what I had to do? I had to look in the mirror and say, the sacrifices that I'm making right now that my children will never even remember, you know, in a year or two, the sacrifices I am making right now for my family will allow me to provide for them and allow us to live in a way that we would never be able to live if I weren't willing to make those sacrifices right now. And that's what I did. I did whatever it took. I worked. You know, my team name is Team No Sleep. And the funny thing is people think it's like, oh, I can't be on your team because I like my sleep. It's not about not being able to sleep. It's about success never sleeps. And when you have a passion for what you do and what business you promote, whatever business that is, you know how, like, people, this is a great example. This is a great analogy. You know how people stay up late because they have so much to do, right? And they look at the clock and they're like, oh, man, it's 2 in the morning. I'm only going to get, you know, 4 hours of sleep before I got to get up and I got to do all of it. That's why, like, people who have a different mindset than people like you and I, entrepreneurs, right? That's the way they think. Because they're just like, oh, I'm only going to get this much sleep. I got to get up and do it all over again, right? Do you know how I live? Do you know what my mindset is? And it's probably yours as well if you're watching this on your internet marketer. My mindset is if I look at my watch and I've been working because I'm excited about what I'm doing and I'm talking to people and I'm helping them, and I look at my clock and it's midnight or 1 or 2 or whatever time it is, it doesn't matter. Even if it's 10 at night, it doesn't matter. I look and I know I got to get up at 6 and I'm like, man, I only have to go to sleep for X amount of time before I get to get up and do this all over again, right? Because I'm excited about what I do. And when you're excited about what you do and when you're passionate, those three C's I talked about, when you have that, it exudes from you. People can feel that. You think that people can't understand or feel how you feel when you talk to them through the internet? They absolutely can. You know what I mean? Like, so as far as my family goes, you know, I did what I had to do. Sit in front of the TV. It'll be okay, right? And within a year, this is an amazing, amazing thing, right? Within a year, my mother-in-law had come up to visit from Florida, and we had just bought a brand new Suburban, which we'd never had a new car for in our lives. We'd never afford one, right? And my daughter was in the living room, and my mother-in-law and I were standing in the kitchen, and my mother-in-law was telling me how proud she was of my success and what I've been doing in my life to turn my life around and have a brand new 300 grand home as a first-time homeowner, right? That's crazy. And, you know, new Suburban, all this stuff that I can afford to buy now. And my daughter came from the living room and ran up to her and pulled on her shirt, right? She pulled on her shirt, and she said, Gigi, Gigi, because her name's Glenn, so they called her Gigi. And Gigi looked down and said, yes, Samantha. And she said, my mommy was born to change people's lives. Do you know what that meant to me? Like, to have my daughter look at my mother-in-law and say, my mommy was born to change people's lives. Let me tell you something. That is incredible, because look at the person I used to be, right? I made a decision to change my life. And everything that you do, this is so key. You know, people are like all the time, should I create a fan page? Should I create a separate Facebook page to market my business? Should I just, I'm like, no, be yourself. You be you, hashtag you be you, right? Be yourself, because people want to deal with people who are real. They don't know if you're real, if you're always spinning a link and all this stuff. I share the good times in my life. I share the bad times in my life. Now, I don't ever talk negative, because there's no benefit to anyone in that, right? But sharing everything is so important, because someone, somewhere, needs to hear your story, period. There are ways that I can help people that no one else watching this call or on this call right now would be able to help them. And there are ways that everyone on this call right now or watching this call right now can help other people that I would never be able to help them in, because we each have a different story, and someone somewhere is waiting to hear exactly what you have to say. It's amazing. And the way that you impact people and influence people, like your kids. Another example, I was at an event, and my daughter had been trying to learn how to ride her bike without training wheels for a while. And I actually did a blog on this, too, and put the video in there and everything. Well, I got a Skype right before I was going into one of my events, and it was her. And she was standing there. My husband was on the phone at her, and she was standing there looking at me on Skype, and she was like, Mommy, I have something to show you. And so, like, on Skype, while I'm at an event, right, he's holding the phone, she gets on her bike, she rides all the way to the end of the driveway, all the way back, no training wheels, helmet, everything, and then, like, gets off the bike and drops the bike, right, and she looks at me, and she said, Mommy, I had a dream that I got up one day and that I could do it, and I decided I was going to do it, and I came out, and I just did it. And I was like, where did this come from, right? Not that my child's not brilliant, because she is. All parents think their kids are brilliant, and they are, right? But the way that you live, the way that you live impacts every single life that you touch. Of course, especially your kids. But do you think that my daughter ever would have just had that fearless belief? Saying I can do it means I can do it. Dreaming I can do it means I can do it. No fear, just getting out there and doing it and not allowing anything to stop you. Right? It's absolutely incredible. And the thing is, everyone is so like, I don't know what to say, I don't know what to do, I don't, who do I talk to, how do I do this, how do I do that? Don't stress. We overcomplicate. Just talk to people. Just be you. You be you. And you have no idea what you'll learn about freedom, that you really have an extraordinary power. Every single one of us has an extraordinary power to influence and impact people. It's an amazing responsibility, right? And it's an honor. So that, I guess that's a little over answer on the family thing. But, you know, I just did what I had to do, you know. Set them in front of the TV. It's not going to tell them. They'll be okay. You're doing something that is going to change their life forever. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Can you hear me? Oh. Okay, good. Where do you put, like, the skill set of learning the marketing versus really telling your story and being that personality? Like, how valuable is it for people to start having the personality or building the skill set, like knowing how to write blog or knowing how to syndicate blog? Like, where do you kind of balance them at? Because, I mean, it's great to tell your story, but if nobody sees it, what do you do? Can you?
Yeah. I am muted. I'm trying to mute myself when you talk so we don't have an echo, so I was unmuting myself. You know, the funny thing is, and it really is kind of funny, it's kind of comical, I was not a blogger at all. Like, I'm like, what's a blog? You know, I mean, seriously, I was not a blogger. I'm like, I have no idea how to blog. Like, again, overthinking. I don't know how to say things and rank things and how can you get people to see it if you don't know how to rank it and all this keyword and SEO, what's that? And all this stuff. And I'm like, ain't nobody got time for that, right? I just wanted to help people and I just wanted to talk to people on Facebook, which is what I did. You know, going into groups, going to liked pages that I liked. Like, I'm talking, hey, this is nuggets right here. I hope you guys write this down. I'm talking about massive pages. I'm talking about, like, NFL football team pages that have millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of people. NBA teams. Like, I'm a sports person, so this is the kind of stuff I chose, right? You know, I'm going in and scrolling like pages and seeing what people are talking about, seeing what people are talking about, looking at what people are saying and the comments they make on things that you are also interested in and interacting with those people, right? Because you have something in common. And sharing who you are in your story. And that's really how I did it. Like I said, I wasn't a blogger. I didn't blog for like 9 months. And the great thing is, this is what's so amazing about team. My team said to me, and I felt like such an idiot, they're like, you know you blog every day, right? And I'm like, what are you talking about? And they're like, what you do on Facebook is blogging. I'm like, no. And they're like, you know, when you feel a certain way or you have gratitude, you know, you get down, you sit down and you write these long posts. You know, hey, this is what happened today, and this is the way it made me feel, and I just wanted to share it with you, right? They're like, that's a blog. And I'm like, okay, you know, so then it was like, all right, well, I copied that and pasted it into a blog, and I'm like, well, how do you get it to rank? And, you know, I was frustrated. I would get on the phone with my web developer and, like, be in tears, and I'm like, I don't know how to make things rank. What is SEO? I don't want to do keyword research. And then finally, I figured it out, because the biggest thing for me is I refuse to sound like a robot, you know? Because when it comes to blogs, you know, you want to use repetitive words. Use repetitive words in your, like, keywords in your blogs to try to get it to rank and stuff like that. So when you read a blog that has ranked well, you can tell that it was written to rank. Does that make sense to you? Like, if you read something, you can tell it was written to rank. And it's like, nobody wants to read that because it doesn't even sound like a normal, like, person talking. When I read something, it's like when people read a book and they get into it and they can't put it down, it's because they're involved in it. They feel like they're right there. They can hear what they're reading. And so what I did was I learned how to be repetitive with the keywords and all the stuff like that. But when people read my blogs now, it's like they can hear me speaking because I write the way I talk, right? And the amazing thing, I thought this was super cool, it was crazy, there's a book that I did a review on, and it's a child's book. I did a review on a child's book, and it ranked like top 6 or 7 front page Google. And the next thing I know, I got a message from the author of the book. And I was like blown away, and she was like, hey, just want to know, you know, who you are because you outranked me on my own book on Google. And I like messaged her back, and I'm like, how did you guys find out, you know, about that? And so she's like, well, my husband always checks it and stuff like that, and you like took all the top spots, and we were just wondering who you were and, you know, how you do what you do and stuff. And I thought that was super cool when you can outrank authors on their own books. You got to be able to engage people, and people cannot be engaged when they're reading something that sounds robotic. People want to read something that just, like, you could write a 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 word post, which, like, a lot of people say it was a big no-no for blogging because it's so long, but if you can segment it up with pictures and you can write in a fashion that makes the reader feel engaged, like they can hear you talking, then they'll stay on forever and they'll subscribe to your blog. But the biggest thing for me and what you were asking in the story versus blogging and marketing is I didn't blog because I didn't know how and I was scared to try. And then even when I figured it out, I still blog. I'm not as consistent. You know, we all have our downfalls. I'm not as consistent with it as I would like to be. I want to get back into doing it every single day because I'm exceptionally strong in doing it now than I was a long time ago. But I really just love to talk to people. I really just love to market, hey, you know, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I work from home. I love what I do. I don't have to have inventory, and I don't have to do this, and I don't have to do that, you know. And I've been doing it for almost 4 years. If you, you know, are interested in the same type of thing, then, hey, hit me up, right? And people will tend to gravitate back to you when you go with it to them passively versus, oh, are you sure? Do you have any questions? Are you sure you don't want to sign up? Like, you know, things like that, because then they feel like you're being desperate and they're pressured. And, you know, I tell people, I'm like, if you want to sign up, I'm here, right? Like, if you don't, that's cool, too. It's no sweat off my back if you don't, right? One of the greatest benefits of owning your own business and working from home, whatever your business is that you get to make the rules, right? You don't want everyone who wants to sign up with you to sign up with you. You know, you get to pick and choose. So hopefully that answered your question.
Absolutely. So you're basically saying just inject your personality into your blog and just be more yourself. That's great. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Hey, Laura, I wanted to ask you, I know that you're right now, you have to have kind of like a regimented schedule being an entrepreneur. So you have to schedule out your time throughout the day. Walk us through a typical Monday through Friday schedule for you as far as marketing. What's your DMO, your daily method of operation?
You know, it's funny that you asked that. I should charge you for me to answer. No, I'm just kidding. It's funny that you asked that because we all do that. You know, I used to do the list. Who does the list? Everybody's got an A-type personality does the list, right? Like, and the funny thing is, I got to show you. So, like, I would get on that board every day, and I would make a list of everything that I needed to get done. Now, this list included things that marketers do every day, which is market, email your list, right, post in whatever groups or whatever, but then you have your normal stuff, right? Your normal stuff, like take the kids to soccer, pick up the kids from gymnastics, get the dry cleaning, put gas in the car, go to the grocery. Like, your list is everything that you do in your life, right? And the funny thing is, how many of you have ever noticed that when you do a list like that the same things get carried over to the next day? And what are those things that get carried over to the next day? I guarantee you they're the same for everybody that's a marketer. Marketing and emailing your list. And why do they get carried over to the next day? Because when you look at that list of all that stuff you have to do, you're like, oh, I got to pick the kids up. Well, I got to do this. Well, I got to do that. Oh, marketing, I'll do it tomorrow because I do that every day anyway. Email my list, I'll do it tomorrow because I do that every day anyway. And then the funny thing is tomorrow comes, and then it's at the top of your list with the rest of your list, and it gets carried over again because you put everything else in front of it. And then it doesn't get done. And what happens? Your house burns down, you know, speaking. So I have this great example, and this is an absolutely true story in regards to making choices about prioritizing. When I first started really becoming successful in the internet marketing history, I got like tons. I would get over 100 friend requests a day, right? And messages out the yin yang. What are you doing? I want to do what you're doing. Sign me up. Where can I go, right? And so what I did, I felt overwhelmed. So I told my husband, I said, I'm going to stop marketing. Like, I'm not going to market today because I need to catch up. Because I felt like if I didn't respond to these people, accept friend requests, and talk to them, that I would lose them and their business and being able to help them change their life. So I didn't market one day. And I, like, worked on catching up. Well, then the next day came, and I was still behind. And I still hadn't caught up. So I said, I'm not going to market today. And I, like, worked on catching up, right? Well, the third day came, and I was all caught up. So I was like, sweet, good. I'm ready to go. Well, guess what? I didn't have no leads. Why? Because I had stopped marketing. And what people don't understand is, like, yeah, it can be overwhelming. You get all this stuff going on, right, coming at you. People want this, and they want your time here, and you need to schedule this and whatever. But don't ever stop. Don't ever stop, no matter what, because when you stop, it's like turn the faucet off, right? You never want your faucet to be off. You know, you can get to people as you can get to them, and like, because we all want to do everything, get everything done all at once. But when you stop marketing because you want to catch up, you'll quickly realize that was a big mistake because then you have no one to talk to. So I learned that a long time ago. So as far as my daily, you know, method of operation, you know, I have the okay, I'm going to email my list daily. I want to post in groups, or I want to talk to people. I want to talk to at least 10 people a day. I want to get 20 leads a day. You know, I do all that. But the funny thing is I don't do lists anymore because I know me, and I will do the same thing that I used to do if I do that list. And I don't want to do that. So the thing about having a family and kids is, and everyone knows this, is that you can't control, like, if the school calls and says, your kid's sick, you got to come pick them up. You can't control if you get up in the morning and your kid's sick and you can't send them to school and you have plans to do this, that, or the other. Your plans change. Like, you don't have an option, right? But there are a few things that I require of myself. So I might not have I'm going to do this at 7 o'clock. I'm going to email my list at 3 o'clock. I'm going to post in 10 groups between 4 and 5 o'clock. Like, I don't do that because that's impossible, at least for, in my opinion, for someone with a family, because it just doesn't work that way. Because then when something interrupts it, your whole schedule is thrown off and you feel overwhelmed and frustrated, right? So, like, my team no sleep thing, this kind of plays into it too. And it's funny you asked that because I talked about my team about this on Tuesday. I said, whatever is on your things that you want to do, like your list or whatever, and the example I used was like taking your kids to the movies because a new movie just came out recently, a kid's movie. I think it's like Kung Fu Panda 3, right? So let's say it's Friday and you want to take your kids to Kung Fu Panda 3 and there's a 6 showing and a 7:30 showing and a 9:20 showing or whatever, right? And that's on your list. And you've got all this stuff you got to do, marketing included, you know, getting 20 leads, whatever, and that's on your list too. And you're looking at your list and you say, oh, well, I'm going to put that tomorrow because we want to take the kids to the movie. Stop. Do not do those things, right? For me, it's going to bed. I will not go to bed. I refuse to go to sleep, period. I will not go to bed until I have X, Y, Z done. That's it. If I want to go to sleep, my ass better get on the ball, period. If I want to go to bed early tonight, then I better make sure my stuff gets done. I told my team, if you want to take your kids to a movie, you want to treat your kids and spend time with them, then you need to make sure you get 20 leads a day. You need to make sure that you've emailed your list at least once a day, preferably twice. You know, you need to make sure that you're talking to 10 people a day, that you've got a schedule going on, that you've been in your back office and you know who to follow up. Like, these are the things you need to do, and you are not allowed to do anything else until you get that done. You want to have fun, right? I mean, you work hard, you play hard. You work hard, you play hard, and just set it up. You can't. If 6:20 roll or 6 o'clock rolls around and you're like, oh man, I missed the 6 showing. You want to make it to the 7:21? You better get on the ball. You miss that one. Oh, there's only one more at 9:45. You better get on the ball. You miss the 9:45. Then you got to look at your kids and say, I'm so sorry. I didn't get my work done. I can't take any movie. Because answer this, like humor me this. What if you had a real job, right, out in the world? You think your boss is going to let you, like, not show up to work because you've got to take the kids to gymnastics or you want to go to a movie or whatever? No, you are expected to suit up and show up, and if you don't, you don't get paid. The benefit of what we do, at least inside of MLSP, I can't really speak for what other opportunities people might be doing, but at least inside of MLSP, we have walk-away residual income from day one. So it makes life easier. You know, you don't have to grind all the time because once someone joins, as long as you water that plant, right, and you don't set it off in the corner, and you take care of it, and you keep it right here, your people will stay with you forever, right? And then you have the benefit of being able to, you know, take some time off or do this or the other and still have income coming in. But you can't forget the important thing. So my daily method of operation is I make sure I get my shit done before I go to bed. That's my daily method of operation.
That's so awesome. That's so awesome. Yeah, I want to also ask, what is your inspiration as far as people in the industry or any motivational leaders that you look up to as far as in your business that have really transformed you?
Okay, sorry, I was just unmuting myself. You know, the funny thing is I had never been to an internet marketing event before in my life, and there was an event in San Diego in 2012, and I went to that event. It was the first ever event, and there was a gentleman on stage. His name is David Sharp, and he spoke hope and inspiration into my heart, and let me tell you why, all right? His story is like my story, right? His past is like my past. It wasn't the best of past. We share, you know, commonalities in regards to, you know, addiction and things like that. And so to see someone on stage sharing their story, making millions of dollars or whatever, and I'm sitting out here like, who is he? Like, if he can do it, I wasn't that bad. Like, I can do it. And it spoke hope and inspiration in my heart. And I went up to him when he came off that stage, and I looked at him, and I said, my name is Laura Parrish. I've been sober for 18 months. I'm going to be on stage at the next event. I'm going to be your next leader, and I'm going to have a big-ass banner at your next event. And he looked at me, and he was like, I believe you. And, you know, damned if I actually knew if he'd believe me or not, but I made a commitment. And then the funny thing is the next day he came off stage and walked up to me in the audience and asked me to stand up. I have this on video, too. It's hilarious. He asked me to stand up and share with the entire audience what I had shared with him the day before. So then I was, like, being held accountable in front of, like, 3,000 people at the time, right? I was like, oh, I better do this now because now I've told everybody I'm going to do it. But the thing is, you know, you don't know who your David Sharp is going to be, right? That's who it was for me. It happened to be someone on stage. But the thing is it was about the story. That's the connecting piece. Because I heard someone speak who had something similar in their past as to what I had. And I'm like, if he can do it, I can do it. We come from the same place. And that's why I talk about it's so important. That's why we talk about going to events and how important it is to go to events. It doesn't have to be someone up on stage. It can be the person sitting right next to you. It's amazing that we have this technology, the internet, that we can connect with each other and talk to each other on Skype and live and do stuff like this, and you can really get to know who people are. But when you can sit down and break bread with someone at an event, you like there is so much wealth in that. It's just absolutely unbelievable. It's worth more than anything. It really is. You know, and for a long time, and Dave will tell you this, I don't know if he's on this call or if he'll see the recording, but for a long time I always gave him credit because he is the person who spoke hope and inspiration in my heart. But he told me to stop. He was like, you're the one who's doing this. You're the one who's changing your life. I lit the match. But see, that's the thing. I could inspire you. Anyone on this call right now, Scott, whatever, could inspire you. And that's great. You know, it's like if you go to an event and everybody comes home and they're like, oh, I'm so gung-ho. Oh, I'm going to change my life. I'm going to do this. And then like 2 weeks later, it's like back to the same shit it was before. No. Someone can inspire you and light that match, but it's up to you to keep the flame burning, right? It's up to you to make that decision to keep the flame burning. So I love Dave Sharp. He's obviously been a big inspiration to me. I listen to a lot of Tony Robbins. I love Tony Robbins, just the mindset, and I read lots of books. I have quite a few books I could like pull off the shelf and like lay them out for you. yeah, I love Tony Robbins. So that's another person that I really listen to a lot.
I have two questions. And hi, Laura. I said hi, Laura, and I didn't realize that my microphone was muted, so you didn't hear me when I said hi. So hi.
Hello.
So I have two questions. The first one, I'm interested in what you said about the three C's. You said culture, community, and compensation. Can you go a little bit over culture, exactly what you mean by that?
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, that is so awesome. You know what? I am a huge believer in no such thing as coincidence. I don't know if you guys out there watch this or not, but I just don't believe that there's anything such as coincidence. I believe that everything happens for a reason, right place, right time, right? And it's so amazing that you just asked about that because something amazing has happened. And for my team members on this right now, they're probably just dying laughing, okay? Something amazing has happened since I started MLSP back on December 19th. And it really, this is going to teach you about culture, all right, completely. It has nothing to do with internet marketing. And it has nothing to do with MLSP, right? It has nothing to do with anything other than creating a culture. And I would actually, it's funny because I actually wanted to get a sip of my drink, but I haven't yet because I didn't want you guys to be like, what is that? But this is what I want to talk about. Okay, so I'm going to take a sip of my drink, right? This is my drink. Okay, this is a 100-ounce Big Gulp cup from 7-Eleven. And let me take a drink and then I'll tell you. So I have this drink, and this was inspired by my mother-in-law, because you can get one of these for like 10 bucks, and then I fill it up at Sheetz, because I like Sheetz fountain soda better. I fill it up at Sheetz for 88 cents. 88 cents! Like, you can't get a regular cup that's this big and pay 88 cents to fill it up. So why not have a thermal mug that doesn't have condensation, fill it up for 88 cents, and it stays good, the ice doesn't melt for 24 hours, right? So I decided to get on board with it. Well, the funny thing is, I joined MLSP. You know, I'm bringing people in, and I always have this with me. Like, everywhere I go, I'm, like, drinking my Diet Pepsi, right? And the next thing I know, one of my team members put some pictures up on her Facebook page and in my group, and it was a picture of a 7-Eleven sign, and then it was a picture of her like that. She had taken a selfie with this. And then she did a video and put it on Facebook, and I'm like, oh, my gosh. And she lives in Chicago, and she went and bought one. And I'm like, that's too funny. She, like, wanted to have one like me, right? Well, then, 2 days later, there's a mother-daughter duo that are on my team, and they also live in Chicago. 2 days later, there's a bunch of pictures that come up. And I'm like, holy shit, we're going to be trending on Facebook, right? They took a picture. They did a selfie. They both had gone and bought one and did a video and all the stuff, right? Next thing I know, my entire team, okay, is buying these things. Or if they can't get them where they live, and some of them live out of the country, they're messaging me, and I finally put up in my group. I'm like, look, y'all saying you can't get them, PayPal me $20. I'll buy you one for $10 where I live, and I'll ship it to you, okay? And I've been doing that. Like, I shipped out five a couple days ago. And that is what culture is. I don't know if you can understand that, but that's what culture is. See, this has nothing to do with internet marketing. This has nothing to do with anything other than it's a crazy-ass big drink that I, as their mentor, as their leader, just happens to use as my drink. But culture is about wanting to be a part of something, wanting to belong to something, something greater than yourself that really doesn't have any massive significance except that this is a big-ass drink, right? But it's funny. It's a part of who we are, what we do, you know, inside of our team, and it's a joke. And it just creates camaraderie. You know, and it's turning into something bigger because I have a graphic design artist on my team, and guess what she's doing? She is now going, I shouldn't be telling you this because you guys are going to find out at Live the Dream 7, right? She's creating a TNS MLSP thing for these. So when we come to Live the Dream, we are all going to be sporting these, and they're all going to say TNS MLSP, and people are going to be like, that's incredible, right? And everyone's going to be like, where can I get mine? That's creating a culture, okay? Does that make sense to you? And one of my team members actually did a blog on it about creating culture, and she took a bunch of pictures of us with these cups and stuff, and I'm going to be doing a video here on it soon because it's amazing how something that, like, really means nothing, it's a $10 cup, right, has, like, really influenced and changed my team. So that's creating culture.
I really like your crunk cup.
Oh, my gosh, it's amazing. On it.
It's called Crack Bucket. Yeah, we call it my Crack Bucket because no, they do. Like, it's everything we write. It's like hashtag Crack Bucket. It's so funny.
$20, huh? That's it. $20.
So then
that gets you one in the mail.
Yeah, man. They're $10.52, and then I ship it. And it was actually, like, really expensive. One of my girls lives in Canada. I went to the post office, and they're like, $50. I said, you are on crack. I am not spending $50. So I sent it regular mail instead of priority, and it was still $24. And I like, messaged her. I sent her the receipt. I'm like, you need to send me some more money. I was like, I said, that was $24 a
That's awesome. So
what's your other question, hon?
Well, now I have another one. So culture and community. So now it's community. You said that, you know, people want to belong. And so I guess I kind of felt like that kind of seeped into the community part, or it's kind of blending into it.
Yeah, absolutely.
How do you build community?
Well, let's talk about, you know, we're all representatives. We're all part of MLSP, so I'll just use that as an example if that's okay. You know, like, you go into the MLSP main community group, there's over 17,000 strong, right? And like I said at the beginning of this call, you got Brian Finale, right, the owner, founder, whatever, of the company, like, just, like, right in there, talking to everybody. You got a question, like, my first pay, I couldn't find the ID, you got to have the security ID to get paid, and I, like, put a thing in there, and I was like, help! And 2 seconds later, I found it, so I deleted my post. And I guess Brian had already seen it in, like, 2 seconds, because then he created his own post, and he's like, hey, Laura, did you figure it out? And I'm like, holy shit, he saw that? Right? It was only up for 2 seconds. I'm talking about a community where you're involved with a group of people who just want to help. It's not about self-service at all. It's about being a part of something where you edify and lift other people up and you share in their joys and their successes. It's about giving to even as a part of community when you don't benefit yourself in any way. Like, I will go in there, like, if I, you know, have free time, my kids are in bed, you know, I'm up, team goes to sleep, whatever, and I'm just, like, you know, strolling around or I'm done with whatever I need and I'm just messing around on the internet, I'll go in the group, right? And people, you know, sometimes people ask questions. There was a lady who was like, oh, I can't get my autoresponder to work. And I don't know who it is. She's not on my team, right? Whatever. But she's part of the MLSP team, which means she's part of my community. And I'm like, hey, what's the problem? What do you need? And we went back and forth and just trying to help her, right? It's about responding to people, talking to people, being concerned about people, providing and servicing people, even when you don't get anything in return, paying it forward, and just being involved in that. It's like a family, right? It's literally like a family. You're just not blood. So being a part of a community that's so strong like that is amazing. You know, when I hit L2 and they put it up in the group and everybody was like, congratulations, there must be like 500 comments that said congratulations. I didn't just put one comment on there that said, hey, thanks everybody for congratulating me. If you go find that post in that group, I replied to every single person who congratulated me one by one by one because it's showing that you take the time to acknowledge people, that you care about people, that you're happy to be where you're at, right? If I have, you know, a tip or a trick or a tool or something that I'm doing or I'm using or an inspirational post or a pay proof or whatever that I think will benefit the community, I go into the community and I'm like, hey guys, you know, happy Friday, it's Laura Parrish, and you know, I came across this great thing and I just want to share it with you, right? No self-serving, nothing to benefit me, no money to benefit me, nothing. You know, just to help other people in their lives and in their businesses, because see, that's why I do what I do. And when you do what you do to be of service to others, the money, it's just second nature.
Thank you so much. So now, the original second question. So I use Facebook a lot, and I love learning about how other people use Facebook for their business, whether it's like networking. Well, usually it's been, I guess, several people, if not most of the people that we've had, use Facebook. And they all use it a little bit differently. And so I'm wondering how it is that you use Facebook.
Absolutely. I think I touched on it a little bit earlier, but basically I share my life. I share who I am. Before I got into the internet marketing industry, I was one of those people that annoyed the piss out of everybody because I was like, it's 5:30 and I just made dinner for my family. And people are like, who cares, right? You know, and I'm like, it's 7 o'clock, I just put the kids in the bath. You know, and people are like, why do you share that stuff? It's 10 o'clock and I'm still awake. You know, I mean, I was one of those moms. And then when I got into internet marketing, it was just a no-brainer to me because I was like, I don't know anything else but Facebook anyway because that's the platform that I've used to have adult interaction outside of being a mom. Because when, you know, if you're a stay-at-home parent, whether it be mom or dad, you know, and you want adult interaction in the outside real world, usually the internet and the Facebook is how you do it. So I had already been using the platform as an individual to communicate with adults. And I'm like, well, if I have no problem putting out there, hey, I'm doing my dishes, hey, I'm doing the laundry, hey, I'm so awake, hey, I got the kids in bed, then why can't I say, hey, you know what? I just got started in this amazing business, and this industry is literally changing my life. And a lot of people, you know, have this, they can't get over the hump of, I don't have proof. I don't have proof. I don't have pay proof. I need pay proof. I need to show people that this is real. And like I said at the beginning, you can't make anybody believe anything. All you can do is share your experience. And beyond that, they have to make their own best judgment and go with their gut and do what they feel is best for themselves and their family. And that's exactly what I tell people. That's my little spiel to the answer of how do I know this is real. Well, I can't make you believe anything. I can talk to them blue in the face. I can't make you believe anything, right? You've got to decide for yourself. But literally, just talking to people and sharing who I am, and before I had pay proofs, right, and said, hey, you know what? I just got started in this business. I'm able to work for myself from home. And what we talk about in this industry a lot about already believing that you have something. It's very different than lying. Never, ever, 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 ever lie. And I got to tell you, here's another tip, and I'm pretty sure that most everyone knows this, but just in case you're brand new in the industry and you don't know this, I'm going to tell you, all right? Please take this to heart. Do not go in groups and post a picture that you have photoshopped of yourself in front of a house you don't own, a car you can't drive, and money you don't have, all right? Because that is, like, the biggest thing. People are like, nobody's going to click on that, right? It's just crazy. You've got to keep it real. So the biggest thing for me is just sharing who I am. So before I had the papers, before I had all that, you know, I would say, hey, I just got in this industry, and it's changing my life. My life has already changed because of it. Oh, you don't have papers, you don't show this. No, but I have a community and a family of people that are there for me anytime I need help. I'm not stuck. I'm not worried about this. I don't get frustrated. I can't figure something out because I have a community of people that I can go to and ask questions and get answers. I'm not alone. This isn't one of those deals where, you know, you sign up and then you never see your person again, right? This is about a community that is literally here to help you change your life. And my life is changing because of this business. See, people join you if you have something they want, right? I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody can agree with that. People join you because you have something that they want. And if you can show them that you have something that they want, it doesn't matter if it's a pay proof of money or if it's the fact that, you know, you get to be with your family or that you're part of a community, it impacts them. And I'll share this because this is a huge piece of it. This is the hugest piece. One of two hugest pieces that really has gained my success on Facebook. And I shared this on stage in Washington, D.C. back in 2013, I can't remember. Anyway, I was on stage in an event in 2013 or 14, and I shared the story, and this is absolute truth. So I was actually sitting right here, where I'm at right now, except there wasn't a desk there before. That's my assistant's desk. But before, there was no desk. It was the window. You can see it. And my daughter had come in to talk to me or ask me something or whatever. And she, like, you know how your kids would come to you and, like, yank on your shirt or your pants or whatever and be like, mommy, mommy, daddy, daddy, whatever. And when you're busy, you're just like, what? You know, what? I'm busy. And she had done that to me one day. And I was like, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need, Samantha? I'm busy. Whatever. And she's like, mommy, mommy, come here. And so, like some parents do, you know, I'm the first to admit that I've done it. And I'm sure everyone else probably has at some point, too. And you're like, okay, what? Right? So you stop what you're doing. And you get up to go see what it is that they want. Well, I stood up, and my daughter walked me over to that window, and the blinds were open. And she pointed outside, and she said, mommy, a flower's blooming. And that's it. And, you know, in that moment, I knelt down, and I just put my arm around her, and I looked outside, and I said, that's the most amazing thing right now, isn't it? That's the only thing that matters in this world right now. In that moment, I came back over to my computer after, you know, she was done, I was done, and she left, and I got back to work, and I opened up my Facebook, and I said, you know what? Life is beautiful. This business is beautiful. Because just a moment ago, my daughter came up to me, and I was busy doing what I wanted to do, working away, like us adults do, like we do in life. And she was tugging on my shirt and wanted my attention, and finally I gave in and got up to see what it was that she wanted. And she just wanted to show me a flower. See, because everything to a child is important right then, right there, in that moment. It's the most important thing to the world, and the world to them. And we as adults, we, you know, don't smell the roses anymore. We don't take the time to stop. But in that moment, I stopped, and I went, and I saw what it was that was important to her. And then I got up and realized, I am so grateful that I had the ability to be a part of that. Because if I didn't do what I do for a living, if I was stuck in a job, 9 to 5, outside of my home, I never would have had that opportunity to be there in that moment. Ever. Thank goodness for this business. Thank goodness that I have the time freedom to share in the most important moments of my children's life. Because they grow up fast, and I could have missed those moments. I might not be able to be here for those moments. So I use Facebook to share gratitude like crazy. Everything. People are like, I don't know what to blog about. I don't know what to talk about. I don't know this. I don't know that. And I'm like, all you have to do is talk about what you do every day in your life. Did you go buy a new watch today? Where did you buy it from? There's a blog right there. Where did you buy your watch from? What kind of watch did you buy? Write a review. Did you go to the grocery store today? You know, everybody goes to the grocery store. What grocery store do you go to and why? Do you have an amazing product that you use that you love? Do a review on it. You know, did you go to a movie? You're a reviewer. You know, did you have to, you know, go get a new part in your car or whatever? Where did you go to do it? And what part was it or who did it? And was it awesome? And why did you do it? Did you go out to eat today? Yeah? What restaurant did you go to? Did you have amazing service? Talk about it. Everything that we do every single day in our life is a way to market. And if you talk about that on Facebook, you're golden. Now, the only other thing that has really, really gained me a massive amount of success, the best month that I've ever had in the industry is $33,700 in 1 month. And that came from something I call video virality, right? I know that's not really a real thing, but I'm badass, so I can make up my own words, right? So, and that's just, what?
I was just saying, go for it. Make up your own words. Just build them, write them down, use them. I love it. I love where you're going. Honestly, that story absolutely touched me because it is absolutely vital to just appreciate, show gratitude, especially with your children's, for something as small as a flower. Laura, I just want to thank you for saying that because that absolutely touched my heart, and it was just a great story. So just wanted to get that in there. Thanks.
And Laura, I got 6 kids, so you really touched me. Thank
you. Awesome. Thank you. But the video virality, and you know, a lot of people in the internet marketing industry have talked about this. There are people who sell courses on it. I have a Facebook training that I've sold before, and this is part of it too. But so the point is you can find out about this from everybody anywhere. You can find out about it free. You can find out about it by paying for it. You know, whatever. But everybody does it a little bit differently. But finding videos that are extraordinarily popular, okay? And this is why I call it video virality. Man, I'm giving you away some stuff right here. I'm serious. This is why I call it video virality, because anybody can find a really viral video and just put it up with your link on it. Anybody can do that, okay? Anybody can do that. But it's not going to have the same effect as what I'm talking about with video virality, because there's something, when you share other people's stuff, you have to have a powerful, and I mean powerful, segue, okay? If you put a video up of parents singing a rap song about how their life has changed now that they have kids versus when they didn't have kids, what does that have to do with your business, right? You have to be able to powerfully make it so that when people see that video and read what you wrote on it, why that is exactly the way you feel about your business. Right? If you can't do that, then people click on the video and they click on your link and they're like, what does the video have to do with, you know, this business? It makes no sense, and then they exit out of it, right? So having the ability to segue, or another word for that is bridge, the gap between what does this have to do with your business, is a massively, massively powerful thing. I posted a video, and this is the video that really, really, really got me where I got to that month. It's called The Parent Rap. And if you go back on my timeline, February 23rd, 2013, I posted this video. It's called The Parent Rap, and I segued about that video, watched the video a few times, and I wrote how it made me feel, right? Man, I love this video. I watch it over and over, and when I watch it, it's because I know exactly where they're coming from, you know, all the good times in our kids' life, all the bad times, you know, the mad times, the sad times, the happy times. I wouldn't trade a moment of missing any of them versus having to go to a job. I'm so grateful that I'm able to do what I do from home and, you know, be able to financially provide for my family and not have to miss a moment of any of those times. If you're down with The Parent Rap and interested in, you know, doing what I do, click here. Hello, I got 16 signups in one day, and I can tell you right now, that video is still populating. I get people in the industry still. They'll take a screenshot of it because someone will have shared it on their Facebook page, and it says Laura Parrish, February 23rd, 2013. It's got over 1 million like shares, over 900,000 comments and likes, all this stuff. It's still circulating. They'll send me a screenshot of it, and they're like, this shit's still going around. I'm like, yeah, you know, like, but it only works if you can really, really segue it, because it doesn't make any sense just to put up something viral and attach a link to it, because people are like, don't understand how it correlates. But if you go back on my Facebook page and you look at a lot of the videos I've put up, you'll be able to read what I write versus what the video is, and you can see that everything that I put up segues into my business. And the biggest way to have success, in my opinion, is when you no longer are separate from your business. And when I say separate, I don't mean like you don't do it anymore. I mean Like, it's not like, okay, this is my life, and I'm going to work 9 to 5, this is my business, and then when I'm done, I'm done for the day, right? My husband used to get really upset with me when we would take vacations when I first got into this industry, because I would take my phone with me everywhere I went, and, like, even on the beach, like, I would, like, take a video, oh, hey, guys, it's Laura, you know, I just wanted to shoot a video and let you know I'm on the beach or whatever. He would just give me that, like, look, like, why are you working, right? And I really, and he gets it now, right? He gets it now. But I really had to share with him and help him to understand that there is no Laura Parrish without what I do for a living. And there is no business without Laura Parrish, because I'm one with it. When I pick up my video to do a video, I'm not picking up my, or my phone to do a video, I'm not picking it up because I feel like, oh, I got to market it. I got to work today. I haven't worked today. Like, if I don't put something out, I'm not going to make money, right? That's not why I do what I do. When you stop worrying about making money and you start doing what you do because you want to share with the world what you're doing and your success and your passion for it, that's when money starts to happen in your life and in your business. So, you know, I don't get the evil eye anymore because it's just who I am. It's just what I do. If I'm grateful and I have gratitude on my heart, it doesn't matter where I'm at, what I'm doing, if I got makeup on, if I got no makeup on, I don't care, okay, because it's real. I pick up my phone and say, you know what, I just want to share this with people. Because it's important. There is no separation between myself and my business. We are one. And actually, I have this. You guys should look this up if you don't. If you've never heard of this guy before, it's on my board here. His name is James Michener, and it's just a little quote. And I put it on this pretty background, and I'll read it to you. It says, "The master in the art of living makes little distinction between his work and his play, his labor and his leisure, his mind and his body, his information and his recreation, his love and his religion. He hardly knows which is which. He simply pursues his vision of excellence at whatever he does, leaving others to decide whether he is working or playing, because to him, he's always doing both." And that's just the way I feel about my business. When you can come to that spot, everything will change for you. Everything.
That's awesome. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Sure.
Thank you.
Well, Laura, it is a little bit past the hour mark. I did not want to stop you because we were so involved in listening to you. And I just want to just ask, is there any final parting words that you'd like to share, words of wisdom, or something that you'd like to share with all the listeners out there?
I guess the biggest thing is never quit on yourself. You know, so many times people are afraid, oh, well, if I quit, you know, my sponsor will be mad, or somebody's losing money because I quit, or whatever, and so they don't talk to people. The biggest thing is communication, and understand that when you quit, you're not quitting on your sponsor, you're not quitting on, you know, the team, you're not quitting on the business, you're quitting on you. And you have to ask yourself, are you a priority in your life? You know, I use this example about, you know, if someone were to kidnap your kid, and, you know, say, hey, you know, you got 24 hours to come up with $5,000 or you're never going to see your kid again. People would beg, borrow, steal, do whatever it took to come up with $5,000 because the priority would be getting their kid back, right? And what I tell people to think about is, why are you any less important? Why are you any less important? Because you have to be able to take care of you and do what you love and what you're passionate about. Those three C's, have an amazing culture and be a part of an amazing community with a compensation plan that will allow you to have true freedom. And when you can have those things and be passionate, then you become one with your business, like I just talked about in that James Michener quote. And then everything will really begin to change for you.
There it is. All right. Well, I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Sam, Miguel, thank you so much. And Laura, thank you again. We appreciate you. And if you would like to go ahead and find out more about how this wonderful thing called MLSP can change your life, change your business, there's a link somewhere attached to this video. Be sure to click on it. And with that, I want to wish everybody a great evening. We'll see you all next week.
Thank you.